My name is Samuel Mosperen. I have been working in the Finnish National Agency for Education in Koski project for a few years, developing the system. The presentation that I'm about to give you is roughly split in half. The first half, I'll explain to you what is Koski, what is being used for, and how it's been operated, and then in the end I'll show you a little bit about the Mairita pilot that is currently being developed there. And I saw a few screenshots from our testing environment how it is supposed to be working. So, Koski in a nutshell. Koski is a relatively new registry. It's based on the law which came into effect in the beginning of this year. And the point of Koski is to take the study records and study rights that are available into one national registry that are currently being, before Koski was taken into production, they were distributed all around different systems in schools, and there were no single point where these study records could be archived from. So it will be, and they are stored in one data warehouse. The diplomas and certificates are in electronic form, and the sharing of information to officials can be quick through the service. The authorities can access the data. I'll explain to you it a little bit later on how it works. And also the real-time information is available for decision makers. So, very high-level picture of the Koski architecture. So in the blue box in the middle is the Koski Register database called National Register of Primary Education, High School Education and Vocational Education. And also it has this service for sharing student data. And the law requires in Finland that all comprehensive schools, high schools and vocational schools send the student data, student information into the Koski registry whenever there is any change in the student information. For example, if a student passes a course in the vocational school, the law states that within 24 hours, if the API is used, it is transferred into Koski. So Koski contains really real-time information about the studies in Finland. Also, Koski is connected to the National Registry of Matricular Examination. Whenever a citizen logs into the Koski service, the Koski user interface shows the data that is in the Koski's registry itself, but it also makes a query to the Registry of Matricular Examination, and if data is found, it's being shown in the user interface. And same goes to the universities and universities of applied sciences. That data is not directly in Koski, it's in Virta registry, which is being queried every time when student logs in into the server. So basically, a citizen can see the history of all the education in these different school types, system schools that he or she has been studying. And when the law came into force in the beginning of this year, it required that in these comprehensive schools, high schools and vocational schools, all the students that are being active in the school at that moment, their student records need to be transferred into the system, into Koski, and from that moment onwards, all the data needs to be up to date all the time in Koski. So the student records before 2018 is not in there, but for example in the Registry of Matricular Examination, it contains the data from the year 1990, and the Virta Registry contains the university studies, depending on the education school, roughly from the year 1995 onwards. So, a few points about utilizing Koski data. Citizen can see his her study information in Koski service, in the study info service, which is called Oma-opintopolku in Finnish. And you need to do your identification by identification bank codes, mobile certificate or certificate card. And what does the secure availability of this real-time student data enables? Well, better planning, recognition of skills, qualifications acquired from previous studies, tracking progress and attendance. And then there's this functionality of sharing information by creating a link, for example, when applying for a job. This is sort of a My Data-ish kind of a feature that is actually in there already at the moment, where a citizen can create a temporary link in his study records, and for example, when applying for a job, give this potential employee this link and say that, okay, here's my study records in course registry. You can check my how I have been doing in my school, what exams I have done, and what degrees do I have. Also, the plan is to use COSCE for calculation of funding distribution because it gives you directly for the authorities the numbers of students in different schools and educational institutes. The idea is to use it for compiling statistics and also for evaluation of education. Okay, then COSCE data and numbers. When the law came into effect in the beginning of this year, it required that the schools that do have to transfer the data into COSCE database, they have to do it within 2 months, so by the end of February it should have contained all the data that has been written in the law that should be in the database is there. And at the moment, this is from the last week's statistics that I checked them, there are currently over 1.1 million student rights transferred into COSCE service, COSCE registry. Of those, is over 600,000 is comprehensive schools. In high schools, there's 130,000 study rights, and vocational schools over 300,000 study rights. Also, this information sharing through link, it has been used during the last days for thousands of times, and before that already, so I could say that it's been used already for tens of thousands of times. And there's also a link to the statistics page of COSCE, which is tells you the real-time details about the data in COSCE in more detailed way. Unfortunately, it's only in Finnish. Okay, then to the My Data pilot that is currently being developed in COSCE. This is a good example of utilization of the data in the COSCE service. It's an ongoing joint pilot with Finnish National Agency for Education, Population Register Center, Ministry of Finance, and Ministry of Education and Culture. A functionality will be built in COSCE, which enables citizens to allow access to his study data for a third party. There will be a consent registry, where citizens' consent is being stored and checked whenever a third party requests the data. This consent can be cancelled at any time. In this pilot phase that we are developing, the information that is being given in this pilot is only that whether citizen is student or not. And even this status information is not, it's not just a simple Boolean value saying that yes, no, this person is a student, but actually contains quite complex information about the, how the third party must understand that whether this person, for example, is eligible for the benefits that students normally require. COSCE in itself doesn't interpret whether someone can be seen as a student or not. It just passes the information that is being stored in the registry. And so in no student records, no degrees or different, course numbers, for example, cannot be in this state accessed. Only those information that are used for checking that person is a student. To access the data, the third party needs to be connected to Suomi.fi data exchange layer, or Palveluväylä, as it's in Finnish being called. The service is accessible only through it. And in this pilot phase, the consent register is part of the COSCE architecture, but in a later phase, the COSCE consent register will be a part of the national consent registry. And also there is an audit log for citizen, so that the citizen can see that who has been accessing the data. And then there's an architecture picture. On the upper right-hand corner, you can see the citizen who is giving the consent in the Studio Info Open the Talk service. And this consent for this third party is stored in the consent register. And then the on the left-hand side, you can see these different third parties, for example, HSA, Helsinki Regions Transport, with whom the Koski team is currently developing this pilot. They want to check that whether the student whose consent has been stored in the consent registry is eligible for student benefits. And then they make the request through the Suomi.fi data exchange layer. It goes through the connection server, which is in between Koski and the exchange layer. A certain adapter there that we are using that makes it into a form the request that Koski understands. And then it makes the verification of consent in the consent registry. If the consent is found, the MyData API fetches the data, the student status information from the Koski database, and it goes back to the third party who requested the information.
2 minutes, please.
And then here in the end, I have a few slides taken from our test environment, what it looks like for the citizen when the citizen is using this service by giving a consent. Unfortunately, this isn't Finnish. I'm sorry for that. But basically, here it says that what is happening here is that the citizen is allowing access to the Helsinki region's transport, and it states what information is actually being given there, whether the student is present in the school, and what is the school that the student is actually studying at the moment there, and is present. Also, the user interface gives the list of existing consents. For an example, we have listed two parties, HSL, the Helsinki Regions Transport, and the Frank Students Service. And there you can see that there is the validity of the consent. It's where it starts and where it ends. And the linking on the right is cancelling the consent. And then there is a view for checking out who has been watching my data in the Koski register. There are two different types of agreements when there is this luvanlähde. As I stated earlier, the authorities can have access to the Koski data. And the first one in here, the legal based by Kela, is such an access. Because in the law it has been stated that they require the data that is in the Koski service, the Finnish National Agency for Education makes in this kind of cases an agreement with this authority who needs this data, where the need for the data is going through, and they are access is given to the authority, which is here the Kela case. And then there are Frank students and HOAS, which are being given consent by the citizen, which is the yksilöity suostumus, which says, okay, you have been given right to Frank students to access your student data, so they have checked your student data on this data stated over there. Okay, that was in brief the Koski presentation.